Good morning, students. This is your science class, and we were going through chapter 3, clothes we wear. So yesterday I was talking about how to make fabrics from fibers. We also told about natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Now we are coming to how to take care of your clothes. Now clothes, when you wear any cloth, it has to be washed well with good soap and detergent to remove all the sweat, dirt and stains. If you don't remove these small insects, they are going to attack your clothes. Okay, now what about woolen coats and trousers? You cannot wash woolen coats or trousers in plain washing or use any detergent on them. They will damage your clothes, they will shrink your clothes. So woolens cannot be washed by plain washing, but you have to dry clean them. Now what do you mean by dry clean? In dry clean, they don't use water, but they use chemical liquid to dry clean your clothes. So you have to give your dress for dry clean if you are given, if you are using next woolen clothes. How to take care of your woolens. Now woolens and silk, they are attacked by small insects such as moth and silverfish. Now silverfish is not a fish, it is a wingless insect. Now looking at this, this is how the cloth is damaged. If you can see small holes, these are holes that small insects have made. Now coming to moth, how does a moth look? This is a moth here. Okay, now this moth is not what damages your clothes. The moth lays eggs on the dress material or wherever it is damp or it is wet, they lay eggs. And what happens is, after the eggs hatch and in the larval stage, this is the larval stage of a moth. Okay, so these insects actually, they eat your dress and damage the dress. Now what is a silverfish? If you have seen, these are they are called silverfish. Okay, you can see them in between books also. They can also be found in cupboards, in your clothes. So they also eat clothes. This is very commonly seen. Now how to keep them away from your clothes? So to store these clothes, you should keep moth balls. Now what is moth balls? These are small white balls. If you see here, these are moth balls. We also call these naphthalene balls or camphor. Okay, what we do is we put these in between the clothes and the small insects. They don't attack the clothes if these are present. They are insecticides and are very dangerous. So children should not play with these naphthalene balls or the moth balls. Okay. Even one more way of keeping them away is using dried neem leaves. Now this is a these are neem leaves. Everybody has seen neem leaves. So what we do here is we dry these neem leaves and then make small pouches. If possible, you can make small cloth pouches which can be filled with these dried leaves and then keep them in between your clothes. This will also keep the insects away. Now that's it in your chapter. Now coming to the keywords, please write these keywords in your copy: natural fibers and synthetic fibers. So what are natural fibers? Fibers that are obtained from either plants or animals are called natural fibers. Synthetic fibers, fibers that are not found naturally and are made by man are called synthetic fibers. So these two you have to write down in your copies. These are the definitions of natural and synthetic fibers. Now summary. So what we have learnt in this chapter is clothes protect us from. Why do we wear clothes? They protect us from sun, rain, cold and insect bites. Second was, we wear clothes according to the place and the weather of the place. In summers you wear cotton clothes, in winters you wear woolens. Now third is, clothes are made from natural as well as synthetic fibers. We learnt about the natural fibers and the synthetic fibers. Last one is, we should store silk and woolen clothes with moth balls and dried neem leaves. Okay. Next, now in page number 36 of the new book, they have given you this exercise. So let's remember. Right S for summer, W for winter, R for rainy seasons. Now I have just given you the 7 questions. Now you need to write in front of these if it is summer cloth, winter cloth or rainy season cloth. So you have to write S, W or R. Please do it on your own in your books. This is very easy and I'll be giving you the answers tomorrow. Next is in page number 38. This is also there in the new book only. So please do it. I have written this only for the people who don't have the new book. Now, sort the following into natural and synthetic fibers. Now, cotton you need to write, is it a natural or a synthetic fiber? Linen also, nylon, silk, polyester and wool. So in front of these, you have to write what fiber is it. Okay. Now, the next one is circle those that are good for taking care of clothes. The options are moths, mothballs, dried neem leaves, silverfish and small insects. You know which two we use to take care of our clothes. So please circle them. And now let's recall and let's observe. Okay. So it is same in the new book and in the old book. Please complete those. They have given you clothes. Protect us from columns. So you need to write the answers there. Types of fibers, you need to write two types of fibers, what I have taught you. Now the examples also you need to write. That's in let's recall. And the next one is let's observe. In that you need to look at the picture given below and draw a similar one in the grid. You have to draw the same picture in the grid they have given you. When would you wear this cotton dress? You need to write if you are going to wear this cotton dress in summer or in winter. And in next class, we will be taking the test paper of chapter 2 question answers. That's it for today. Thank you so much.